right, we got a couple of changes there. You can see, obviously, we have our UFC Fight Elite Championship match. It's going to be defended with Silva taking on the legend Mark Coleman. But first, a little bit of a dream match. BJ Penn versus Conor McGregor. So here we go. Lance, you know how we're going to do this. You pick the side you want. I pick the side.
I'm going to leave it there.
I want, and here we go.
I'm going to leave it there. I'm just going to wait until you pick the ball.
What if I pick Conor McGregor? What if I pick the notorious one? The notorious asshole. I could pick the notorious asshole.
Coming up next, it's a featherweight matchup between the prodigy, BJ Penn, and Conor McGregor.
What the hell you thought I was gonna do? No, that's the notorious asshole.
The notorious one, Conor McGregor, the first ever two-weight champion back in his home country.
Yeah.
He is as precise as any striker in the octagon today. And the national amateur boxing champion lacks no confidence.
Very high finish rate, creative fighter. Light and fast hand speed.
Conor McGregor is one of the most creative and dynamic fighters in the UFC's featherweight division today.
Why everyone heard
he is
me?
Also one of the most loved fighters to ever come out of Ireland.
Being a notorious asshole.
Conor McGregor back in the octagon.
Prodigy
Brazilian jiu-jitsu black belt
from Hawaii.
The prodigy is one of only two fighters in UFC history to hold the belt in two different weight classes. BJ Penn,
UFC Hall of Famer,
and the welterweight division.
Strong takedowns, which is a weakness of Conor McGregor.
The sport has ever known. His world-class ground game, along with his devastating knockout.
Think I'm a legend tonight.
His love for fighting.
And a ground wrestler, McGregor could be destroyed and exposed.
Our tail of the tick for this featherweight fight. McGregor is 27. Penn is 37. McGregor will have a 4-inch reach advantage.
Reach advantage.
And with the official introductions.
And we talk about the 10 years of experience.
No!
You don't like her being, neither do I. I don't know who's in the main event.
19 wins, 3 losses. He stands 5 feet 9 inches tall.
Now stop your notorious assholeness. It's like Nate Diaz made your ass tap out. By wearing white.
This man is a jiu-jitsu fighter holding a professional record of 16 wins, 10 losses, and 2 draws.
I remember BJ Penn and Frankie Aguilar rules, man. That was class stuff.
Ladies and gentlemen, he is the former UFC lightweight champion and the former UFC welterweight champion of the world.
You talk about a guy who's done it all. He's won 2 different belts in 2 different weight classes. Herb Dean. Yeah, in the same reaction everybody. No, we don't want this Herb Dean.
Herb Dean, our referee for this featherweight matchup. And here we go.
Oh, man, you had no respect for the prodigy.
Black trunks for McGregor. White trunks for Penn. Oh, that one hurt him. Flying knee.
Man, I was trying to go for a takedown, ran right into that flying knee. Not good for Penn.
Big spinning back fist lands.
misses with the kick. Quick kick. Penn with some big kicks. Got hit with a left. He connects with the straight.
BJ Penn got to be a little bit more thing. I think his blood flowing from the cheek of BJ Penn.
Just misses with the left. McGregor caught by that inside leg kick. The huge head kick is blocked. Trying to grab the leg and he
takedown.
And he lands a single leg takedown. McGregor got taken by that right. He escapes and he's back on his feet. Wow, nice front kick. Hard hook. Oh, and he goes up top of the kick. Wow.
And he has a good leg case, good foot movement, but
gigantic.
Oh!
Oh, beautiful.
Oh!
Blocked. Penn gets caught by the inside leg kick. He's doing a great job of mixing things up here, keeping it unpredictable.
Oh, did you see that foot movement from BJ Penn?
Under a minute remains here in round number one. Attempt spinning back fist does not connect. More great kicks from him here.
Big front kick landed.
Joe, he's hurt.
Oh, he can show you a flying knee.
Whoa. Oh, that caught him. Wow, swing and a miss.
Big takedown.
Back to half guard. And the round is over. Huge takedown in the final seconds.
The stand-up definitely favored McGregor to take, but however, the wrestling favored Penn.
A nice knee to the body. And here's another knee to the body.
I think I stole that round.
Incredible striking.
Yeah, I had you against that cage, and BJ Penn with that master feet work didn't let you get away from it.
Second round. Good left hook. The damage he has done to his opponent's body.
Whoa.
Is the story of this one. And he connects. Penn's eye looks so swollen now. You have to wonder if he suffered a fractured orbital.
Orbital in the eye.
Look at that, right to the temple. Man, he really turned on that inside leg kick. That's a strong position for him up here against the cage. Now he's got him in the plum clinch. And he eats a knee. Big front kick landed. To the face. Trying to stay out of trouble here. Oh, head kick.
Because I'm not going to run into a haymaker.
He caught
him. Oh! Kicked him out of the air.
Very nice leg kick by Penn. Again, heavy leg kick. Oh, big head kick again, Joe. Wow, he goes down.
Oh, he dives into a huge haymaker.
Can he finish it here?
Oh, no.
solid shot to the body. Oh, nice knee.
No. Yes.
That huge head kick was blocked. Oh, he missed that kick. That's a good kick. Solid leg kick. 20 seconds.
Whoa!
Nice inside leg kick.
Almost McGregor saved by the bell or what? Man, you gotta give that round to BJ Penn. The chant, fans are chanting BJ.
Here's a huge kick that stuns. Here's a powerful punch that devastates.
Kicks that are stunning, punches that are devastating.
And let's see that again from another angle. The lovely Jenny.
The lovely Jenny.
Ready to fight? Ready.
5 minutes left in the fight. Nice knee to the body. He was looking for the head kick, but it was blocked. That head kick hurt him.
What?
Grab the leg, completes the takedown. Nice sweep.
It could have been the worstest thing McGregor ever did.
Rear naked choke. And he gets out of that rear naked choke. He's looking to take the back. Now he moves to full guard. Oh, there he goes. Full mount. There we go. Attacking with the arm bar.
Oh, beautiful.
Almost had the arm bar. He's got the back. This is where he's outstanding. Man, he has landed so much damage that both of his eyes have started to swell now. Nice inside leg kick by Penn. Great use of the kicks.
Back and forth.
The defense of Penn is just too much.
McGregor's knee is blocked. Good knees. They battle in the clinch, looking for a dominant position. McGregor's earned that underhook. Got the Muay Thai clinch. He lands a knee here. He caught with the big knee. He's hurt. That big knee might stop this fight.
Man, how did I didn't get you?
Penn goes to the half guard. Let's see what he can do from here. Penn's got the full mount again. Big shot. Solid strike to the head. And again, he gets back on his feet.
That was a brutal right leg kick, man. He's got some outstanding kicks.
McGregor with the nice jab.
Yeah, but McGregor clearly losing this fight.
Crazy fight, and the pace is still kept up in this last minute. These guys are going for it, trying to finish. He lands a head kick. Nice head kick. And again, head kick.
Whoa!
He is in big trouble here. Oh, he's dead! Oh.
No! 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 No!
Beautiful KO late in the fight.
Oh, there's...
Fuck off! Fuck you! How the fuck? I took the... Shut the fucking ass!
Fuck. Once again, here's our fight replay. Let's see into the replay. This is the shot that drops him. Perfect technique. He's clearly hurt badly here. Let's take a look at it from another angle here.
This is the one that causes the knockdown and the subsequent follow-up strikes for the knockout. Look at this. Boom! And he's out.
Bruce Buffer has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean called a stop to this contest at 4 minutes, 45 seconds of round number 3. Playing the winner by knockout, the notorious Conor McGregor!
Conor McGregor wins by knockout.
Sorry for the rage, fans.
You kept you going like, oh, I'm going with this, moving this way anyway. So you came in, you walked right into two super kicks. What was wrong with you? He's gonna tell everyone he'll never do that.
No, he wouldn't. Wait 1 second, I'm gonna set y'all the statistics because I want to show how I was dominating this fight. I mean, his overall statistics clearly outstriking him, better percentage of significant strike, better takedowns, more takedowns. First round, I was probably the tightest round we fought. But my takedowns probably gave me the edge. This round, I think clearly, they're all tight rounds. Round 3 is the round that really dominated. And it was probably my best round until that last 15 seconds where I lost. So, all right, I got this fight. You get the McDonald Thompson fight. You can get it.
Between Elias Theodoro and
755.
Sam
Alvin. This dude is gonna feel pain if he never felt pain in his life.
Sam Alvin looking very confident tonight as he makes his way towards
from Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Sam Alvin
fired up and ready to fight.
This guy is a very well-rounded fighter. He does not mind standing or going to the ground, and this diversity makes him very unpredictable.
Man, it's truly heartbroken, but we gotta move on.
Sam Alvin is set for tonight's fight. Elias Theodoro, coming off a great training camp, and feels outstanding.
This guy has world-class choking techniques in all varieties, be it guillotine, choke, rear naked, darce, anaconda. If this guy gets a hold of your neck, you've got problems.
He does. He gets a hold of 111 in the last 12 fights. I think he's only has 12 fights in his career, so he's 11-1, I believe.
Elias Theodoro, set to fight Sam Alvin. Our tail of the tape for this middleweight fight. Theodoro is 27, Alvin is 29. He is 1 inch taller. The reach is identical. Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC middleweight division. Introducing first, mixed martial artist on professional record of 25 wins, 7 losses, and 1 no contest. He stands 62 inches tall.
So, me, Sam Alvey, this one of the fights that are actually going to happen. I got like Deodorant. I never saw any of these two fighters. I was just looking at the statistics. I mean, I like to pick the American, but the Canadian and Canada with the judges' favorite. God, like the Canadian. I feel like when they go to these other places, you see fighters, they just sign because they're going in that home state.
Our referee.
And here we go.
Fight scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds.
White trunks for Alvy.
Black trunks for Theodora.
He's looking for a right hand, Mike. Beautiful right leg kick there. Theodoro with a good jab.
Oh, good overhand right.
Powerful jab.
Great job with the roundhouse. Good defense by Theodora. He scores with the leg kick. Alvy with the big jab.
Just trying to keep a consistent pace here.
He looks for the takedown. Oh, that's a great block of the punch.
Oh, very nicely back and forth.
Theodora with a strong combination.
Under three on the clock, round one.
He'll look for the single.
And get the takedown.
And there's the takedown. Got it.
Theodoro's looking for the arm.
He's in full mount here. He's looking for the arm bar. First thing he wants to do is he wants to secure Stop. The arm.
He pulled his arm out of it. He's got his back now.
Half guard right now.
Now he gets the full mount again.
Theodoro with a solid right. Alvy's eyes looking really swollen. You've got to wonder whether or not it's actually a fractured orbital. And again, he's got half guard.
Clean hammer fist.
Good job escaping.
Quick inside leg kick by Alvy.
Good leg kick right there.
Good body shot.
Ooh, nice inside leg kick.
45. Looking for the single.
Another takedown.
Joiner gets taken down again. He really has no answer to the takedown skills of his opponent tonight.
15. He's going for the choke here.
Round one is in the books.
And here's a nice single leg takedown. Let's go to a different angle. And here's a perfect
I'm showing them takedowns right there. Takedown. I did a good job controlling the range and stuff. I really think I dominated that round. You know, it wasn't an onslaught. It wasn't that pace-for-pace back-and-forth action that everybody loves to see. But it was just, I did a good job controlling pace, controlling the action, and I think that's going to do me well.
Ariane gets a set for round number two. Round two.
Good inside leg kick.
Theodoro's bleeding from his right cheek now. Alvy with a solid leg kick. Joe, that's a great kick. Good block by Theodoro.
Yeah, protect that eye right now.
Theodoro with another solid leg kick. The jab connects. Look at the advantage in total strikes landing.
Right now I'm giving up my body because of the cut.
Man, he connects with the right and the left.
He's doing a great job of being unpredictable and mixing things up here.
Joe really starting to see some damage time due to those body strikes.
Couldn't agree with you more, Mike. Nice body shot.
He's looking for a takedown.
I'm trying to catch him with...
He's trying to set up a submission here.
Oh, he's got the choke.
Japanese necktie.
Trying to finish it right here.
Got him!
He got him!
It is all over.
Japanese necktie! Wow. Boom!
He got the choke for the tap.
Should call it the Canadian necktie. That's what it was.
Let's see it again here. Got the choke. It's in deep and no choice but to tap. And here we see it from another angle. Beautiful technique here. And the tap. And here we see it again.
Let's beautiful look at it again. Victory. He's got the arms, but he's got it over top. Instead of all of it over the head and like a guillotine, he has it over the arm and uses his leg kind of on the other guy's arm to use his opponent's own arm to choke him out. Kind of by using that leg to pressure on it. Very intriguing move.
Elias Theodoro, your winner by submission.
It's a good win. That's how you want to win them right there. Cause everybody hugs everybody. And then you gotta talk to Joe Rowe. I feel we choked that guy out. Well, it felt pretty good. It felt pretty good. Choked man out. It felt pretty good. Judges are probably not happy again. We're gonna just stop hiring judges after a while. Don't need them. I mean, judges thought they were gonna feel important after the McGregor fight. What'd they end up feeling? Stupid. I mean, judges are not feeling any like they're worth anything. And these judges don't feel worthy, man. Hey, he didn't land a single takedown against me. I was 2-for-2 on my takedown attempts. I think that was a real difference because I caught him and going for a takedown and get him. And I landed strikes at a better percentage and more high volume. And I just landed significant strikes better than he did. And I was more smarter with my punches. Huh? Second round. It was early second round submission. Mid round second round submission. But here we go. Weidman Silva.
The long-time
middleweight champion,
Anderson, the Spider Silva.
I'm Wyman.
Hold on. Anderson, the Spider Silva, the most decorated champion in UFC history. He opened up his octagon career 16-0. Born and raised in Curitiba, Brazil, the Spider was part of the great shootbox team under the guidance of Rafael Cordeiro with teammates like Vanderlei Silva and Mauricio Shogun Rua.
Anderson Silva has the perfect combination of speed, timing, intelligence, and confidence. He is one of the most successful mixed martial arts fighters in the history of the sport.
Anderson Silva. I don't understand why I can never get to the side that you want to get on. Hold up.
Born and raised in Long Island, Chris Weidman, the first man to knock out Anderson Silva. And it came in Silva's 38th professional fight. Utilizing his Division I All-American wrestling skills, he is ever evolving with his striking game. And is one of the biggest and strongest fighters.
More striking, as a former UFC champion, extensive college wrestling career, and a former US BJJ champion. I don't know what a BJJ champion stands for. I'm going to look, Google that shit. Nah, I don't want to give anybody a BJ today. maybe tomorrow.
Back in the octagon here in Toronto, Ontario.
Except for doubt. Not joking.
Our tale of the tape for this middleweight fight. The American is 31, the Brazilian is 40. The rest is virtually identical. And now with our official introductions, here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is three rounds in the UFC middleweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a Muay Thai kickboxer and jiu-jitsu fighter, holding a professional record of.
Yeah, but I don't understand why I can't get the side that Silva's on. Like, really. Like, I feel like you're getting a jump on me or something. Like, something you're doing. I use an analog stick to move over the directional button. Jiu-Jitsu Championship? Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. He was a world Jiu-Jitsu champion.
Referee for this fight is Eve Levine.
You ready?
And here we go. Tonight's fight is scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds.
Chris Weidman's wrestling and his takedown ability are a huge factor in his success. Keep an eye out for those tonight.
Silva's one of his specialties is his defense.
Nice jab.
He was able to block that big punch to the head. Solid jab.
That's a big uppercut he just landed.
Use a lot of his defensive movement. Head and feint. Oh! That signature leg kick back Wyman up. Let's go, Wyman, chance for the All-American here in Canada.
There's a nice kick to the body by Anderson.
Inside leg kick. Inside leg kick. Oh, that hook did damage. Oh, big body kick.
Oh, yeah, you did. I give you that.
Nice job slipping the punch. Good inside leg kick by Weidman. He's got heavy leg kicks. Nice job avoiding the leg kick. Weidman with a big leg kick. Joe, that's another solid kick. Weidman with yet another leg kick. Both men throwing frequently. 1 minute remains in round one.
Excellent head movement.
Good kick from Silva.
Plenty on the clock. Weidman with a big hook to the body. That's the end of round number one.
I'm trying to be smart with it. Trying to be smart.
Let's take a look at some of the action from that round.
There's a look at that. Lyman. All over the place.
Another beautiful leg kick. And there's another excellent.
Oh, come on, I don't think you were that good. I don't think you were that good now.
Some really well placed strikes on display in that round.
No, why, man? I want to be Brazilian.
The beautiful chin.
Ariane. Brittany Dunn. They fired Brittany. No, I don't know about Brittany. Maybe she don't go to Canada. I don't know.
Joe, looking at that last round, Anderson Silva's ability to land multiple body shots may very well be wearing down his opponent.
Yes, I agree. He landed some tremendous shots to the body, and those are very effective.
Anderson likes to counter, okay? If you go back to the fights in the back...
And he pulls away.
That was not good right there.
He's got very good takedowns, but we have yet to see any attempts in this fight. Kind of surprised he hasn't looked for a takedown yet in this fight.
Missed on the takedown attempt. In close inside leg kick.
Weidman with the combination.
Nicely done. He slipped the punch.
Shit.
Finally, the fight is on the mat. Look out for some vicious grounding pound.
Oh, with that a was right. A hard one.
Oh.
Beautiful reversal.
He's got both hooks in.
He's going for the choke. He's free from the rear naked choke. He's going to try to take the back, I think.
Side control.
And he connects.
Good slip of that punch. Oh, huge kick to the midsection.
Tags him. Wow, big shots there by Weidman.
That was a nasty elbow. Swing and a miss. Let's go. Final minute of round two.
Take down.
Here he goes. Side control. Nice.
Man, this crowd is very loud and very supportive of the All-American, Chris Weidman. That's a solid straight. Another big shot to the head by Weidman.
Looking for the suplex.
And that's the end of
round. And Weidman. I think I got some momentum in that round.
And here's a nice kick to the body that lands. And here's another kick to the body. And here's one more perfectly placed kick to the body.
And they're fixing up Silva's eye.
The beautiful card.
All right. Third round, right? Of our third fight. Indeed it is.
5 minutes remain in the fight.
Joe, that was a good round we just saw. It'll be very interesting to see if the fighters can keep this pace though. I think they will keep this pace. I think they're actually going to probably start turning it up a notch as we head down the home stretch.
In the clinch. The spider with a nice hook from the clinch. Good jab.
Really threw everything into that uppercut, but fell short.
vicious elbow.
Big elbow.
And a knee.
He hurt him with that hook.
No, oh, what the heck?
He did a nice job blocking the head kick.
Whoa, good flying knee. Silva maybe knowing that he needs to win this round. But maybe going away from his original game plan. Oh!
Gotta be careful here.
Good takedown.
Look at this, takedown.
Solid right hand.
Now he's in full guard.
Guillotine.
He got free of the choke. Big punch from the bottom.
Weidman's taking some hard shots on the
back. It appears the cut on his cheek is getting worse. Postures up.
Dumb mistake.
Fighters in the UFC today.
Side control.
Nicely done.
Good control. Postures up.
Big
oh,
right
he
hand.
Rocked him with that right hand.
Oh, huge elbow.
Oh, this is ugly, Mike. Oh, and big shot from the top.
It's over.
Over.
Wow. Oh, my God.
And a dumb takedown. He got caught that elbow. What a horrible officiating.
Let's look at the replay and see the end of this fight. This is the huge ground and pound strike that lands for the KO. Let's see if we can get a better look.
That caught right in the back of the ear when you're trying to turn. And look at him coughing locks.
Great angle.
Watch it. He's trying to turn. We're not going to get a bad angle here, but he hit him right in the ear and that coughing lies them.
Bruce Buffer has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee.
Again, the judges are feeling unimportant. It's just an uneducated takedown attempt, and Wyman made you pay.
Chris Wyman, winner by knockout.
Alright, so now we have the women's fight. I'm gonna let this one play out. We're gonna chill and relax, commentate the fight, give ourselves our opinions about going into UFC 200. But let's first, before we do that, let's check out the fight statistics of the Wyman Silva fight with Wyman. Silva definitely had more significant strikes, but Wyman landed a better percentage. It's also landed a better percentage in total strikes. Takedowns, I don't know why Silva attempted 11 takedowns. It just seemed really dumb. Silva's not a ground fighter. I don't know why he would go for that many takedowns. Definitely 8 takedown attempts in the third round. It was really, really is considered why he changed his strategy. The first round he had success doing classic and vintage Anderson Silva and bobbing and weaving head movement. When he was trying to do flying knees and all that stuff, it's not Anderson Silva. I don't think he did a...
I think
you got frustrated. Don't be blaming this on Silva. You're not that good. You ain't that goddamn good. All right, well, we're going to talk about UFC 200 here because it's... We had, what, a major update from the last time we did this broadcast that Brock Lesnar is going to be on UFC 200? Like, Brock Lesnar? I mean... I kind of speak as a wrestling fan because I am a wrestling fan, but I also speak as an MMA fan as well. I know a lot of people say, well, what does it matter to Brock Lesnar in there? Well, WWE-wise, wrestling-wise, this is huge. Brock Lesnar fighting on a thing that he could actually... Because we all know the UFC is real and wrestling is scripted, because I hate that word fake. It's not fake. It's real injuries. I can't wrestle. I couldn't do it. I'm not athletic gift enough. George Clooney can't go out there and wrestle. Okay? It takes athletes to go out there and do it, even the non-talented ones. Terrifying on the feet because of this. Okay. I mean, it's truly astonishing what to do. But besides that, for Brock to go in there and fight, I mean, we all know Brock was a champion in MMA, I mean, UFC. I mean, to beat Randy Couture. I mean, he did have lose his last two fights, lost to Campbell Aston and lost to Overeem in pretty convincing manner. But I'm very interested to see. I mean, as a wrestling fan, I'm interested to see if he wins, how is he going to be packaged up in WWE? I mean, you can't have him. I mean, he's got to come in WWE. He's going to fight at SummerSlam. People know what I'm talking about. He's got to be clearly better than everybody in the WWE locker room. I mean, he's got to be built that way because he's going to get mainstream attention. But it also could be used to get over a young star that they beat a guy who beat a UFC star. But if he loses, then it's very interesting. What do you do with Brock? I mean, do you let that loss just simmer out of people's heads for a while? So very interesting. I mean, the match was going to be Mark Hunt. I'm looking forward to seeing Mark Hunt and Brock Lesnar. I don't know if it should be that high in the card. I agree. I know a lot of people don't like it being over two title fights and then being the co-main event. But Brock's the guy who main evented UFC 100. And if you're talking about drawing power, he does have that. He still remains the biggest box office attraction in UFC history. So, I mean, Brock's the man at that point. He knows how to draw. He's the biggest draw in the WWE, probably next to... maybe right below Cena right now, but I think he's overtook him. So, I don't know. I mean, it was definitely huge. I mean, the fight itself, I mean, hearing Brock doing the UFC 200 promotion tour and all that stuff, getting ready in training camp, I mean, it came as a huge surprise. Now, also other things in UFC 200, but, I mean, the Brock Lesnar thing really letting me simmer in on that one because it's definitely something that's going to be very intriguing to see how people take to it. I mean, I know some people, and I'm going to try to find it real quick, see what people are talking about. But I read it, I mean, a lot of people are hype. Other people are like, oh, no, he's a fake wrestler. Stick to the fake wrestling. Again, it's scripted. It's not fake.
Good shot now to the bottom.
And
they have started this fight off with a brawl.
See if this fight goes long or goes short. Last time I had one of these fights, it went real short. It was like over right now.
Brutal strikes landed.
So I want to control what I'm saying right now, but... I mean, right here. I hate this. Just throw.
Trying to take the back here.
But, I mean, Brock Lesnar, I mean, it's definitely a lot of talk going on. It's definitely UFC 200 has gotten even bigger. It was already big. And I know a lot of people saying, well, they need that because Jones is not the draw that Conor McGregor is. And I guess he's not to that certain extent. But Jones is a guy I think we're going to remember a year from now. I mean, I understand that UFC 200, but UFC 200 is going to be a thing that we look back on. Like UFC 100, Brock Lesnar was a star at the time. He's not a star anymore in MMA, but he's still a star somewhere else. So long term, it felt good that Brock Lesnar did main event that card. And you have George St. Pierre in the co-main event, who we all know from long term now. But Jones and Cormier being that long term, I think we're going to remember those names down the road more than maybe Conor McGregor, who, and I still believe, is a flash in the pan. I mean, maybe we'll remember Diaz, of course. But I think years from now, we'll look at that card and say, what the hell? Why are these two in a non-title fight, nonetheless, the main event? I mean, McGregor and Diaz, I understand what people are saying, oh, it lost its draw, but the fight is going to happen. It's not like UFC 200, I mean, it's going to be a huge money draw now, and now a McGregor-Diaz card is still going to be a draw down the road. So I think UFC really got big. I mean, I don't understand why people are saying, well, it's like at one time you could say, okay, they lost it because they lost the money they made in McGregor. But McGregor and Diaz are going to get it on. It's going to happen. It's what it was announced in August. That they're going to fight in August. So the fight's going to happen between those two. It's no doubt now. Well, I can't say no doubt. Injuries. I mean, it was supposed to be a no doubt before. So we just have to wait and see. But the fight's going to happen as far as everything indicates right now. So, I mean, I don't think the UFC lost out in anything. Right there, they're just looking at each other, looking deep in each other's souls or something. I don't know what's going on. But, I mean...
And the round comes to an end. And here's a nice shot, lands perfectly.
It's very intriguing. I'm looking forward to it.
And here's another
UFC 200, definitely going to be even bigger now. Or Brock Lesnar's inclusion. And I don't know, Mark Hunt is not the greatest fighter in the world, but he's still a pretty good fighter. He can still give a lot of people in mixed martial arts a lot of issues. I mean, Mark Hunt is not a title contender right now, but he's still a guy who could be a third fighter in the card kind of guy. I mean, he's still a very good draw. So Mark Hunt, I mean, Brock Lesnar is not... Mark Hunt's going to be no scrub and no easy opponent for Brock Lesnar. It's not like they got some guy that wasn't even in the UFC. I mean, this guy's a UFC fighter. He was a UFC fighter for a long time. So, I mean, it's going to be interesting.
Big front kick. Nicely done. Good left hand by Coleman. Feints with the kick. Excellent job of timing these combinations. That's a solid punch by Coleman. Very nice kicks.
Whoa! Whoa!
That's a huge
Is it
hit.
Over? No. Thought it was over. It could be over. It is over.
It is all over. Just like that.
Wow.
Wow.
Ground and pound KO.
Let's check out the action on our fight replay.
And let's take a look at the replay. This is the shot that drops her. Perfect technique. She's clearly hurt badly here. Let's take a look at it from another angle here. This is the one that causes the knockdown and the subsequent follow-up strikes.
Got her with a kick that knocked her down and got her on the ground. Hit them big punches.
And that is all she wrote.
Bruce Buffer with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Mario Yamasaki has called a stop to this contest at 48 seconds of round number two. Playing the winner by knockout.
Oh, look at this. And we know that Brock Lesnar and his theme song was actually Enter the Sandman by Metallica when it was in UFC originally. But now WWE will allow him to use his WWE entrance theme song. So the key is we use Enter the Sandman. But WWE has allowed him to use his own theme music. So you could hear dun 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 dun. That's me and my pure impersonation. All right, guys, we're going to just let you look at the screen for a little while. Well, I take a short break, and when we come back, we have the co-main event and the main event. go. We're back. We are back. Next fight, McDonald and Thompson. Lance, you can handle this.
Coming up next, it's a welterweight matchup between
Rory McDonald
and the Karate Kid.
And the Karate... Lance. Rory McDonald. Canadian, you're picking in the Canadian hometown.
Stephen Thompson, coming off a great training camp. He's ready to put on a show.
He's a very disciplined striker, Mike. He's got great, well-rounded, fundamental skills and always comes in with a smart game plan and sticks to it. He's got a lot of respect for every opponent he faces, and he has the
Stephen Thompson's a former kickboxing champion at Kempo Karate, and he's only lost one fight in his career.
Stephen Thompson enters the octagon, ready to go to battle.
Whoa, what the hell?
Born in beautiful British Columbia, Rory McDonald, one of the most promising young talents to ever fight in the UFC. Rory made his UFC debut back in January of 2010 when he was just 20 years old and had a record.
Well-rounded fighter, good punch and power. Has won 18 fights in his career.
Most technically sound fighters in the UFC today. He is also one of the
technically
best
sound.
Of the
He's
new
very well-rounded
fighters who have learned from the beginning in a full spectrum of mixed martial arts techniques instead of relying on any one individual discipline.
He's not a one-round fighter. He's learned the first fighters be trained. I mean, when these younger fighters come up, they've been trained to do mixed martial arts and not from a different background like Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, then do MMA. This guy was trained as a mixed martial artist.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is three rounds in the UFC welterweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, a mixed martial artist on the present record of 12 wins, 1 loss.
12 wins, 1 loss from Simpsonville, South Carolina. Fight now. The Wonder Boy. I think Thompson's going to win this fight in real life. I really do. I think America goes into Canada and smack them Canadians around. USA! USA! No offense to any Canadian viewers. Herb Dean.
For this welterweight matchup. Here we go. Fight scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds. White trunks for Thompson. Black trunks for McDonald. Always a fairly impressive athlete as well. Jonathan Chambers, the longtime strength and conditioning coach for McDonald. Really talks highly.
Outside trap. Gonna get in the top mount. Posturing.
Attack there. Full guard. He postures into place.
Good work from the bottom by Thompson.
Come on. Should have could have went for a submission there for McDonald.
Caught him with a left.
Still look good down there.
McDonald with a good leg kick.
Oh, his leg kicks are brilliant here.
Both men exchanging.
Man, he's timing his kicks well.
Yeah, I really got figured out how to take that off. I think it's good at times because, I mean, you're still learning. I mean, I'm always learning.
Under three. Oh, man, that leg kick did some damage.
Another takedown here. Big takedown.
Goodness.
back. Now he's in full guard.
McDonald with a good punch.
Now he's moved back into full guard.
Good defense from Thompson.
Big roundhouse kick.
Caught him with a punch.
Oh, good leg, good body kick right there. Oh! The stanky leg. Yeah, but Thompson, you're going to find his favorite move. He gets some time to wind up.
Lands a giant kick.
Yeah, he's educated. Whoa! And Thompson getting some chances to tee off with some shaky defense. And McDonald with a takedown.
And he postures up. McDonald with an elbow to the head. Huge hammer fist.
Oh, got your back. Got McDonald's back here. Put some guard up on that shit.
He's got his back.
Wow. They are on their feet.
Yeah, but he almost had you right there. I'd like to see what that holding knee breaker would done. Yeah, but he was punching you right in the head. You had to guard that head.
Here's a powerful knee to the body.
Herb.
And here we see a perfectly executed suplex. And here we see a devastating suplex. We really got a chance to see some awesome action in that round.
The beautiful Ariane getting us set for round.
Beautiful Ariane going to get us set for round number two. Wait, the judges have not been important. The judges want to judge a fight. They want to judge a fuck fight.
Round two.
Hashtag save the judges. No respect? Yeah, America, baby. USA, we don't have no respect for nobody.
Oh, huge suplex.
Oh. Oh, I thought he was going to bring you up and take you down.
Wow! Man, he's in big trouble here. Oh, he completes the suplex
right there.
Submission, maybe.
And it is all over.
What? Man, Herb called that too early. I thought he was guarding himself. I thought he was
at the end of the fight here, this is a vicious series of strikes, ground and pound, that lead up to the TK.
Ain't her messed this up.
On a different angle. Yeah, there are some big shots getting through here.
Why are we watching Herb's ass?
Ground and pound combination that leads to the TKO. And here it is from another angle.
Here is Bruce Buffer.
I ain't heard made a mistake. That fight could have went a little longer.
Earns the victory by TKO.
Boy. So, good fight. We're going to get ready for the main event, which is our EA Sports Fight League title. Bigfoot Silva defense against the legend, Mark Coleman. So, 56% right there on the significant strikes. But McDonald definitely threw a lot more significant strikes. Takedowns, yeah. Roy McDonald definitely landed them takedowns. He threw a lot. I think he threw more dub in that first round. Yeah, with the bulk of it. And the head attack from Roy McDonald, them kicks, they were definitely significant. Main event! And only Bruce Buffer will do it good, so I'll shut the fuck up. You have time, because Bruce Buffer's going to Bruce Buffer's gonna do what Bruce Buffer
coming
does.
Up next, it's a heavyweight showcase between Antonio Bigfoot Silva and the Hall of Famer Mark Coleman. UFC heavyweight champion.
As he makes his way towards his cage, he believes this is his time. He believes he is destined to take this title. His preparation for this bout has gone absolutely according to plan. He's in fantastic shape with a great game plan, and he expects to walk out of his cage tonight as the new champion.
Mark Coleman steps inside the octagon, ready to do battle.
Oh, here we go. He's got a big foot. A big ass foot. Because he got a big ass foot. A big ass foot. He's got a big foot. Big foot. Oh, yeah, yeah. He's got a big ass foot. Big ass foot. Big foot. Big ass foot. A big ass foot. He's got a big foot. A big ass foot. He's got a big ass foot. A big ass foot. He's got a big ass foot. A big ass foot. The legend is younger than Silva, and he got him probably at his last fight. I don't know.
This is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, the referee in charge of the octagon, Eve Loving. And now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the Air Canada Center in Toronto, Canada, it's time! A welcome for the undisputed UFC Heavyweight Championship of the World. This is his first fighting at the blue corner. This man is a wrestler, holding a professional record of 16 wins, 10 losses. He stands 6 feet 1 inch tall, weighing in at 235 pounds. Fighting out of Columbus, Ohio, presenting the challenger, Mark the Hammer Coleman! And now, introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner.
Got a big ass foot.
He is a mixed martial artist, holding a professional record of 19 wins, 9 losses, and 1 no contest. He stands 6 feet 4 inches tall, weighing in at 264 pounds. Fighting out of Coconut Creek, Florida, USA. Ladies and gentlemen, presenting the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC heavyweight champion of the world, Antonio Bigfoot Silva.
UFC belt on the line. Protect yourself at all time. Obey my command at all time. If you want to touch love, do it now. Go back to your corner.
Antonio Silva. Ready? Mark Coleman. And here we go.
Championship fight. 5 5-minute rounds. Joe, this championship match
matchup has taken a life of its own. There has been so much back and forth banter, so much bad blood. This is by far one of the biggest title fights in UFC history.
As this fight gets underway, it's important to put into perspective the magnitude of this competition. This is a huge fight, a huge championship fight with massive implications in the entire sport.
He missed that kick.
Silva gets hit with that inside leg.
Look at this.
Big foot, numb feet.
They split.
Knee to the body by the champ.
How you doing, champ, going on?
And they're going to slow his opponent.
Yeah, he's digging into that leg kick.
That's a solid leg kick.
Bigfoot came very close to losing his first match. His title fight last time, but he was able to overcome it with a fifth-round knockout.
We don't see it very often, but when he does throw those kicks like that, they do damage. That's a nice knee by Coleman.
And they're loose.
Solid jab by Silva.
You got them big hands.
Oh, good left hand.
Good takedown.
Seconds.
He missed on that jab. Nice leg kick.
He got tagged there, Mike.
Sure did. Coleman with a knee to the leg.
Inside leg kick lands. Huge inside leg kick.
Oh, nice knee.
Huge kick.
30 seconds. Big right hand.
Dang.
15 seconds.
Hard jab.
The horn sounds for the
big foot. Mark Coleman. Coleman showed why he can do. He could. He's the challenger. Why he's the number one contender. But Bigfoot showed why he's the champion.
And here's another.
Coleman was good at times, but Bigfoot. When Coleman made mistakes, Bigfoot was there and waiting.
And there's another excellent leg kick.
I mean, Coleman did a good job. I mean, I thought Silva had a better round than with Joe Rogan
really
showing.
Excellent striking being displayed in that round.
All right, you with me? Good. All right.
And the lovely Brittany gets us.
The lovely Brittany, Lance, you called for her.
Ready? Okay. Round two. The battle continues, and this top contender continues to be the better fighter. The champion is trying to utilize his game plan, but this contender came to fight tonight. We said he's very confident. You can see that so far in the octagon.
Nice inside leg kick.
Good straight by Bigfoot. All the chance of Bigfoot. This crowd loves Antonio Silva because they know something destructive could happen at any time.
Nice kicks.
Back and forth battle. Silva's bruise on his thigh is nasty. He's not going to have any fun walking around.
Oh, no!
Oh, and down.
Hip escape. Gets out of the full mount.
And lands a good shot. Moves to half guard. Beautifully executed sweep.
Bigfoot with a good punch. Oh, he sweeps. Look at his position now. He's keeping busy from the bottom.
In half guard now.
Coleman with the hammer fist.
sweep. Now he's in the dark. Silva checks that kick. Nice hook. That's a hard inside leg kick.
Looking for the suplex.
Under 2 minutes.
Bigfoot with a nice jab.
And a knee.
Bigfoot some solid knees.
Exchanging knees here in the clinch.
Oh, and another vicious late kick.
He's landing an outstanding leg kick. Trying to get a single.
Good takedown.
Half guard.
Nice sweep. Very good move. Great transition to top position. Good move back into half guard.
And now looking to finish by submission.
Can't hold it.
Coleman with the hammer fist. Round two in the books.
There's a nice leg kick.
I thought I'd beat you in this round two.
And here's another beautiful leg kick.
I'm bruising it bad. Where's the feet?
And there's another excellent leg kick.
Mark Coleman may be showing the world. And he can do this.
Ariani getting a set for round number three.
That's not Ariani. That's not Ariani. Ariani's the other girl. I'm just positive. Ariani's model didn't change from the other time.
Ready?
The third round of this championship fight is underway. He's doing some damage with those kicks. That's a big inside leg kick. And another.
And another hard kick. Now he secured side control. Full mount. And he lands a hammer fist.
Big put some solid ground and pound.
The swelling in his eyes is starting to get worse.
Bigfoot's in side control again. Nice.
No one's ever been.
Joe, that's a heavy inside leg kick. Bigfoot connects. Good inside leg kick by Bigfoot.
Nice knee.
Just over three now.
They're working hard here in the clinch. He scores with the knee.
Exchanging knees here in the clinch.
And he's really doing some damage with those knees.
They separate from the clinch.
Midway point of this championship fight.
Looking for the suplex.
Great work from the top by Silva. Half guard.
And now he's working from full mount. Hip escape, nice hip escape.
Just gonna step right back over.
Half guard.
Nice sweep.
He's going after an arm, he's controlling the forearm. Throws the other leg over the face. And he got it out.
Nice block of the punch to the head.
Better round for me in this round.
Good kick to the leg of his opponent.
Wow, what a back and forth exchange. Oh, hit him with a big knee.
Oh, nice.
Good kicks.
That's a solid hook.
Back and forth battle.
Oh, he's landed some good shots here. Hard straight punch. Vicious combinations.
Whoa!
What a way to work at the
Bigfoot knee buckle. I definitely had the best round, but Bigfoot's got to be concerned about what happened at the end of that round. That knee buckled.
And let's look at that from another camera angle.
Bigfoot's not bleeding or anything. I mean, he's got to have rounds like that if he's going to hold him the belt. What is wrong? That's not Ariane. What did she blow? Dye her hair or something? What the fuck's going on here?
Right for championship round. Uncharted territory for many, but a place familiar for our UFC champion. That said, the top contender, hanging tough, looks very good in this five-round fight. What a back and forth battle.
Joe, we have made our way to the championship round.
This is what separates the men from the boys. This is where the fight gets really difficult. The last 10 minutes of a championship fight are absolutely crucial.
And he's taken down by Bigfoot.
Good punch.
You know, Joe, vision has to have become a concern because both of his eyes are starting to swell very badly now.
Moves to side control. Looking for the suplex. He's got a clinch.
Under three.
Good takedown.
Trying to pass from half guard into side control. Can't make
it. Oh! Beautiful turn!
Beautiful sweep.
Solid shot with the left by Silva. That's an outstanding transition. And connects with the jab.
He's taking some shots
Wow!
Need to get out of there. Let's go. Do something.
Classic Antonio Bigfoot Silva with huge
power. He's out!
It's over! That's what the Bigfoot can do! He has a big ass foot!
Nasty ground and pound KO.
Time now for our fight replay.
Let's take a look at the replay. This is the shot that
got caught.
Perfect technique. He's clearly hurt badly here. Let's take a look at it one more time. Here's the knockdown. Vicious strike. Check it out here. And he's out.
Bruce Buffer has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Ian Vegas called a stop to this contest at 3:03 of round number 4. Declaring the winner by
Bigfoot, still the champ. What is he? What are we? That's the only original champion we have. Him and Gustafson, the two. The heavyweight and the light heavyweight champion, the two original champions, and of course, Holly Holm, but she was from me. She's in this game. We're talking about way back since we started these broadcasts.
Heavyweight champion. And what an exciting card tonight. For my partner, Joe Rogan, this is Mike Goldberg saying so long until we see you next time inside the Octagon.
All right, time to see who was the fight of the night and all that. It was prestigious awards. Bigfoot able to win a fight. No decision. Judges are unhappy. They don't even know why they were here. They just want their paycheck now. I mean, but Coleman was, I think, once again, Bigfoot was on the verge of losing this fight again. I mean, those statistics show you a lot, but let's go to the round by round. I thought Coleman won the first round on me. He did a good job, but I did a good job setting the tempo that I wanted to. In the second round, I mean, I think I got some good stuff off. I thought I won that round, but I didn't hit the significant strike. I hit the significant strikes really well. Coleman went for a couple takedowns. Round three is where Coleman went for two takedowns. I missed the takedown. But again, I set up that pace with the total strikes. I was really good. Coleman didn't have a lot of good defense. And then round number four is where it all fell off for Coleman. He wasn't able to land. And Silva was able to tee off. Not enough defense show from Mark Coleman. And that's why he's going home with the L. I've still got time to WTF moments. Fight, performance of the night, the KO going to Bigfoot Silva. Fight of the night, Madonna and Thompson. And submission of the night to our only submission of the night. So we will be here 4th of July weekend, which is July 1st. The 1st of July. I don't know if we're going to have a card next week. But I guarantee we have a card July 1st. And damn it, Independence Day is not that far away. Fuck, what is it? Two and a half weeks away from Independence Day? Get the fuck out of here. Man, summer's flying by. As soon as you know, it'll be September again. All right, no crying. UFC, this was great. Join us July 1st. We'll be back. Promise.